whiskey lovers, and welcome to another one of Mark's whiskey ramblings. Just came down this slope, which was quite exciting, and now it's time for a small rest, a little reward for all the hard work. And the reward is going to be in the shape of this lost malt. Now, it's not a closed distillery, so it's not a lost legend, but it is a malt that was produced between 1966 and 2000 at the very versatile Loch Lomond distillery. I'm talking about Old Rhosdhu. So that was one of the mashes that they made, and one of the malts that they made at the Loch Lomond distillery, which we all know for the Loch Lomond malt, Loch Lomond grain. They also have the Inchmurrin, Inchfad, and a couple of others. So, like I said, very versatile. But today I would like to talk to you about this Old Rhosdhu by The Roots. The Roots is a Belgian independent bottler, and this is their fourth release, but it is their first single malt. Yeah, they started off with a grain, a cognac, if memory serves, and a rum. So this is their fourth release, their first single malt. Now, if you find an Old Rhosdhu, remembering that this was produced only until 2000, that means that every single malt that you find nowadays is at least 22 years old. Well, I'll have you know that this one was distilled in 1993, making this one 29 years old. Wow, a 29 years old malt, and this is bottled at an ABV of 50.8, so natural cask strength. That's the one I would like to try today in this freezing temperatures, which explains why it is a bit syrupy now. I've had it with me on my backpack while going down the slope, so it's probably very chilled by now. At 50.8% ABV, light golden, which reveals the bourbon cask in which it matured, from The Roots, the Old Rhosdhu 1993 on the nose. Wow, that nose is excellent. It's nice and fruity around apples, some pears, but a lot of beeswax as well. It makes it a little reminiscent of both Kleinleash and Little Milt, so what's not to like? Some rhubarb jam in there, some apricots, but it's also quite herbal. I get notes like hay and raw malt. And all the way in the background, there's this funky note of jute bags, hessian cloth, dried ferns. And all the way in the back, there's this pinch of greffe sugar, that light brown sugar that we put on our pancakes. As I said, excellent. On the palate. Again, nicely creamy in the mouth. Immediately, those fruity notes return, and we are really going on a tropical tour here now. And some spiciness there as well. Think ginger, a little bit of pepper. Oh yes, mid-palate now, I get sultanas, peach, papaya, even some lychee, some canned pineapple, some syrup as well, apple juice. There's a lot going on here. And even a small bitterness as if from the pith of a grapefruit in there that provides a perfect balance. Boy, this is really good. On the finish then. That finishes bittersweet, gently drying, and makes me long for another sip. A fantastic Old Rhosdhu, and one of the tastiest malts I've put to the lips this year. I know, early days. But still, beautiful. If there's any point of criticism, it's probably the price, because this bottle will set you back over 300 euros. But then again, it is almost three decades old after all. Well, and prices nowadays, they're still skyrocketing, so what do you do? But anyway, this is an almost 30 years fantastic Old Rhosdhu by The Roots. So Joran, the manager of The Roots, kudos, my friend, for selecting this beautiful cask of Old Rhosdhu 1993. And that's all for this whiskey rambling from the beautiful Achenkirch am Achensee, the Christlum ski area. Wonderful, wonderful. Highly recommended. Almost as highly recommended as this beautiful single malt. And I hope to see it one of Mark's whiskey ramblings real soon. And until then, may the malt be with you. Bye-bye.